I'm still trying to wrap my head around the virtual reality. Still working with the idea that the tree doesn't exist. And I liked your analogy of bacteria. Mm-hmm. So I was wondering, if the bacteria is in my stomach, I'm in the grocery store. The bacteria doesn't know the grocery store exists, but it does exist. I'm consciousness. It popped into, I'm experiencing the grocery store. Bacteria, mm-hmm. isn't it more of just a matter of perspective, and not that things are popping in and out of existence, but it's a matter of perspective?
That example with the bacteria was one to show limits of knowledge. Okay, you have a greater perspective than the bacteria do. You have more knowledge. You have a bigger picture. Therefore, you understand grocery stores and sunshine and things that lead to food. That was a different analogy. That has to do with just limits of knowledge. The bacteria, no matter how brilliant they are, no matter how good scientists they are, just can't understand rain and sunshine, because rain and sunshine is not part of their reality frame. It's in another reality frame. All that's non-physical to them. To the bacteria, the rain, the sunshine, the grocery store are non-physical. The only thing physical is the GI tract. That's what they experience, you see. So you have a larger perspective, and you can deal with the grocery store. So that's a limit of knowledge. Our perspective only goes so far. And then we can't, where did consciousness come from? Where did that primordial potential energy that got those ones and zeros, where'd that come from? Well, that's like the bacteria saying, where'd that food come from? You get to a point where you can't say. So that was what that analogy was. With the virtual reality, it's basically that everything that we get, all of our reality is generated by data. It's just information. And if you see it as just information to the senses, so it's information to the nervous system, it's the light in the retina produces the electrical signals, produces the neurons bopping around, then that's digital information. It's just data. And that this reality is your interpretation of the data, then it takes just a very small step from there to say, well, the data is not coming really through the senses. The data is just coming into our consciousness, and we're interpreting it with the body, with senses, and this is just our metaphor for explaining the data. See, that's then the virtual reality. And the reason those trees popped up, that was just an example of the fact that in a virtual reality, the computer doesn't generate anything that it doesn't have to generate. So the reason they pop up is because the computer isn't going to just keep those trees, just keep drawing them when it doesn't have to, when it's really not part of the game because nobody's looking at the trees. So in the digital world, they call it parsimony. That's the computer being stingy with its cycles. And that's what drives the virtual reality idea of only producing the data that we need at the time that we need it. And the data is just what comes through our senses. That's how we interpret it.
Doesn't it take more energy just to turn things on and off than it would be to just kind of create it and just keep it there?
No, it doesn't create. It's not more energy. It's just a matter of cycles. It's a matter of computing things. Whether you have to compute, a gigabyte or a kilobyte, it's just how much you have to do. So you don't compute anything you don't have to. That's a waste. You're not really turning things on or off. It's just data. It's whether you compute it or not. We tend to think in physical terms, and we try to explain this in terms of the physical stuff we know, and it just doesn't apply.